welcome to my vegan experiment. My name is Kat, and today I wanted to talk to you about shark feeding or shark baiting diets. Now, as a scuba diving instructor, I am very interested in what's happening in our oceans, and shark feeding is one of these controversial topics which has been going around in the dive industry and other places for a few years now. So, if you're interested in anything to do with scuba diving, veganism, conservation, this is the place for you. Click down below to subscribe, little bell notification button, ding ding, so you get notified. But yeah, let's get into it. So today we're going to be talking about the safety, about the ethical reasons, and about the economic benefits or negative things about the shark diving industry. The first thing I wanted to talk about is what these shark baited dives actually look like. So I've personally been to two or three shark baited dives. One was with the whale sharks in the Philippines, in Oslob, and one was in the Bahamas. Now in the Bahamas, this is Stewart Cove, which has been famous for its shark feeding dives for the last however many years. When I was in the Bahamas, and I've written up a whole article about my entire experience in the Bahamas available on scubanews.com, it was amazing.
On the other hand,
into the water after everything had been perfectly organized by Stewart's Cove, and there were already tens of sharks. Now these sharks were awaiting to get fed. So in the first dive, we were just swimming around, having a good time, kind of letting the sharks know we were there, because they actually respond to the fact that there's a boat there. Just like Pavlov's dogs or cats or whichever one he did, sharks begin to anticipate the behavior and begin to associate boats and divers with food. Now, this can be negative for several reasons. One is they have become much more tame in the sense they aggregate in areas, therefore they might actually be easier to catch, endangering them from overfishing. On the other hand, this might also be altering their natural behavior. While studies conducted in the University of Miami in 2012 showed that tiger sharks did not change their behavioral patterns when it comes to feeding. They still had their hunting instincts, they still went to hunt their prey, and several organizations actually only use tuna heads to feed the tiger sharks because they're very low in caloric density, therefore don't fill up the shark and don't stop them from continuing on their natural behaviors. However, in contrast, in Oslob, which is in the Philippines where whale sharks come, they have only started feeding them in the year 2001, and since then the local conservation environmental group has found that since whale sharks are migratory animals, as opposed to the average 30 days they generally spend in an area, now the average of the sharks spending in Oslob is 44, with one individual actually being written down as spending 572 days in this one area. Therefore, there we see very much how the patterns and behaviors of these wild animals have been altered by the fact that they're being fed. In Oslob, this was a very small fishing town, and they actually counted on going fishing and hunting, and even hunting the whale sharks for their food as well as export to make some money. Philippines was the first country to create protective legislation for the whale sharks, and the whale sharks have brought them such an enormous economic boom that they're now actually on the local currency. The fishermen that now are tour guides in Oslob make anywhere between 10 to 15 times more a day than they used to as fishermen. This also has provided them with enormous stability, benefiting the community and the individual families. While it was a quiet fishing town, now people from all over the world go and travel to Oslob to dive with the whale sharks. Now this is a big contrast to Donsol, where they also have whale sharks in the Philippines. However, unlike in Oslob, where it's extremely crowded, there's about 500 to 1,000 tourists going through this one place, this one bay, in just 6 hours, from the time at 6 a.m. they start feeding to midday they stop feeding. During that time, they put out a net and actually trap the sharks in the bay. Usually between 5 to 10 sharks are hanging around at any one time, getting the food and waiting, letting the tourists kind of hang out. But as you can see from this footage, the shark is almost at a 90 degree angle with their surface, just with its mouth open and waiting for the tour guides, the boatmen, to put food in their mouths. Unlike their natural behavior, which is very much horizontal swimming, enormous distances every day, now they have completely altered their behavior. In Oslob as well, the meeting point where the tourists are taken out is just 100 meters from the shore, and it's about 15 meters deep, so a very shallow area for these huge, enormous animals. Whale sharks grow to be about 12 meters in length and can weigh up to 7 or 8 tons. Now, for them to be in this shallow water is unnatural for them. Usually, they travel from deep to shallow many times throughout the day. While if they're in shallow water, this can cause them to heat up, which puts stress on them, and stress can eventually change their physiology, their mating patterns, their immune system, and in general, their health. As well as this proximity to boats, as I mentioned with the other sharks, recognizing the boats as a source of food means they're also not as afraid of the boats. 47% of all the whale sharks that have been seen in the Oslob area have propeller marks on their back from boats hitting them. In certain circumstances, like in the ones in the Philippines, feeding sharks is altering their behavior and potentially causing significant risk. However, as we saw from the other data gathered, for example, for the tiger sharks, their behavior isn't being altered that much and they're still very much depending on natural prey. Another fear related to sharks and feeding them is associating humans with shark food or shark prey. For anyone who's taken any of my scuba diving courses, you would have heard me repeatedly say, do not be afraid of sharks. We are simply not what they eat. It's like us going into a forest, seeing a random tree, and going like, yeah, that's going to be my dinner. It's simply not in their instincts to attack that big, black, bubble-breathing thing. Now, there have been fears, but if we look at the statistics of all the shark attacks that have happened, there have, on average, been 6 shark attacks a year since the year 1580 to 2012. Shark baiting tourism has only started at the turn of the 21st century, and since then, while there has been an increase in shark attacks, this is probably due to the fact that there's many more people in the water than in the olden times, plus we can also gather data better. If you look at the top 3 places where shark attacks have happened, from the year 2001 to 2012, the first one was Florida, second one was Australia, and the third one was Hawaii. Now, Australia doesn't actually have shark feeding in many places, they only have it in Port Lincoln, especially to attract the great white sharks while you're in a cage, and the areas which have had the greatest amount of shark attacks is actually in Western Australia, around the Perth region, as well as in near Byron Bay, Ballina. And all of these attacks have not been related to shark baiting. In Hawaii, shark baiting is illegal, so again, all the attacks are not related to shark baiting. And in Florida, shark baiting was made illegal as well in federal waters. So if you look at the statistics, you're actually less likely to get bitten in a place where shark baiting occurs. We hear about these shark horror stories on the news. This is simply because of our fear, especially amped up by the Jaws movie. The author of the Jaws book and then later the Jaws movie has actually now become one of the biggest shark conservationists because he understands that the fear he instilled in people making these out to be killing machines is actually part of the reason for some of the biggest shark culls in the world. Now, if we think about the number of sharks we kill every single year, the current estimate from researchers based on data from discards, catches, official numbers, and projections is somewhere around 100 million sharks per year. However, this is a very conservative estimate, with the real number being able to be somewhere within 273 million. Now, you might be thinking, there's not many sharks left in the oceans, and that is definitely the case. And that's why sometimes the alternative of using sharks for tourism and baiting sharks to make sure they stay in one area for the local communities to be able to benefit from them living there is also helpful in terms of transitioning their livelihoods from killing the sharks to having to protect them. With 500,000 people visiting various shark dives around the world per year, that means over 500,000 of people are getting interactions with sharks. Feeding frenzy. So what is the conclusion? The conclusion is shark feeding has shown not to create long-term effects, especially not on tiger sharks, while the whale sharks have been affected greatly in terms of their migratory patterns in the Philippines. However, it has boosted local economies, transitioned from fishing to ecotourism, and has the opportunity of educating the general public. In the Bahamas, $78 million come into the Bahamas just because of the sharks alone. Now this is going towards the shark operators, but this also goes to all the ancillary income which is around it. So the airlines, the hotels, the restaurants, the shops, all the people who live there benefit now because of this regular shark feeding program that happens just off the island of Grand Bahama, where hundreds of people go every single day to see these sharks. Let me know your thoughts down below. What are your thoughts about shark feeding? Would you prefer to see sharks in the wild? Thank you so much for watching. Also, if you want to help me clean up the oceans in the Comoros to try and save some sharks, some whales, some turtles from getting hit in the face by plastic or potentially perishing due to it, please consider contributing to the Patreon fund. With every dollar you donate, it can really help more cleanup dives and more beach cleanups, as well as education for the locals of the proper disposal of plastic. So thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I'll see you next time.